If you missed any part of the Academy Awards, let me get you caught up on what happened.
The World According to Jon.
Hello and welcome to The World According to Jon. My name is Jonathan Paula. Last night, Hollywood hosted the 88th Annual Academy Awards at the Dolby Theater, celebrating the best and whitest that cinema has to offer. It was an evening filled with big surprises, a few awkward moments, and a good deal of controversy as well. Before we get to all that, I want to quickly remind you to check out my movie night special, where I did a breakdown and review of all 8 Best Picture nominees. That's over on my main YouTube channel, Jogwheel. This is the biggest video I produce every year, so it would mean a lot if you took a few minutes to check it out. But now let's get to the highlights and lowlights of yesterday evening. We start with the red carpet before the ceremony, where we had all of the most attractive and beautiful people in Hollywood coming out in their best dresses and tuxedos. Now, I'm not a particularly good judge of fashion, but I wanted to single out 4 women who I thought looked the best of the evening. Priyanka Chopra, star of ABC's Quantico, looked great. So did Alicia Vikander. Brie Larson in a long blue dress. And then Charlize Theron in a red gown with a plunging neckline looked incredible. She gets my pick for best of the entire night. Comedian Chris Rock hosted the ceremony and went right to work lambasting the Academy over the Oscars So White controversy. He opened up strong with a lot of jokes on this topic, even throwing shade at Jada Pinkett Smith for boycotting the event, saying that Jada protesting the Oscars is like me protesting Rihanna's panties. I wasn't invited. I tweeted early during the ceremony that I was excited to see what Chris was going to do after he moved past this controversy and did other jokes. Sadly, he never did. It was obvious that he wanted to address this Oscars So White controversy, but the amount of time the broadcast spent on it was overdone. It was complete overkill. It went from apology to overcompensation to outright pandering, and I think it really stunted the broadcast as a result. It is an important topic, but in the context of a award show broadcast and primetime TV, it didn't make it very entertaining. And the one part of the evening they did go off this script and did something more conventional, Chris went into the audience and tried collecting money for Girl Scout cookies. It seemed like a pretty obvious and desperate throwback to Ellen DeGeneres' bit a couple years ago when she had Brad Pitt pay for pizza. But I didn't really get it. It wasn't funny, and they spent way too much time on it. Speaking of which, in an effort to cut down the speech lengths, the Academy introduced a new scrolling ticker along the bottom of the screen. It seemed like a good idea in practice, except everyone just ignored it. Like, what good is it if you thank everyone on the scroll and then also just say it out loud? It didn't help time on the speeches. I think they were just as long as ever. And then Chris Rock brought Stacey Dash on stage from Clueless for some poorly conceived joke that completely bombed. Everyone in my feed was like, what just happened? I've been pretty negative so far, but one thing I liked were the announcement packages that preceded each winner, especially those for sound editing and best picture. They were extremely well done. Being able to condense a 2-hour film into these 10-second little mini montages, but they did a great job and they were really entertaining. Mad Max Fury Road was the big winner of the evening, winning 6 of its 10 nominations, all in the technical categories. Makeup and hairstyling, editing, production design, sound mixing, sound editing, and costume design, which went to Jenny Beaven, who took the stage wearing a bedazzled leather jacket in what was one of the more ironic outfits of the evening. Pixar's Inside Out deservingly won Best Animated Feature, and its director, Pete Docter, took the stage and gave one of my favorite speeches of the night when he encouraged kids not to get bogged down with all the bad things in life, saying, "You can make stuff." I thought it was a really inspirational speech, and hopefully it encourages some kids watching to go out there and be the next animator for Pixar. Comedian Louis C.K. presented for Best Documentary Short and absolutely killed it. Not only was he totally funny, he also made great points about why this award is objectively more important than some of the others. The nominees in this category are less rich and less famous than their A-list counterparts, and are sharing important messages on real topics. So I thought Louis had a great point on this particular subject, and he was very funny with the material. I hope he comes back to present or even host again in the future. And then we had the president of the Academy, Cheryl Boone Isaacs, basically give a lecture on racism, which one, wasn't needed at all because Chris Rock already covered the topic ad nauseum earlier in the show, and two, it's the Academy that didn't nominate any black people, so you're basically lecturing yourself. Like, what's the point of that? When it came time for the In Memoriam, it seems like the Oscars finally took my advice and had the musical performance run simultaneously to save time. Dave Grohl of the Foo Fighters sang a great cover of the Beatles' Blackbird while we got all the moving images of people we lost over the last year, except for Abe Vigoda, who was strangely left out of the list. When Vice President Joe Biden introduced Lady Gaga for Best Original Song, he also spoke out against sexual abuse, which went great with her performance, which was very emotional and powerful, and it is a great message, stopping sexual abuse. But let's not forget that this is the same Academy that willingly gave triple rapist Roman Polanski an Oscar just 14 years ago. So it seems a bit hypocritical to admonish sexual abusers on the same broadcast you previously celebrated one. Overall, it was a night of big surprises. Mark Rylance beat out Sylvester Stallone in the Best Supporting Actor category. Ex Machina won Best Visual Effects over Mad Max and Star Wars. While Sam Smith won the Oscar for Best Original Song with his James Bond theme, Writings on the Wall. Mistakenly thinking he was the first openly gay man to win, that was Elton John 20 years ago. He dedicated a speech to the LGBT cause, which was nice. But again, like, you should have just fact-checked. There were other gay people before you. The show also had a slew of non-human presenters, including the droids from Star Wars, a few minions, and Buzz and Woody from Toy Story, because they were celebrating their 20th anniversary, and boy, that makes me feel old. Ennio Morricone was the oldest to ever win a competitive Oscar at age 87 when he took home the trophy for Best Original Score for his work on The Hateful Eight, which was very well deserved. He beat out John Williams, who was celebrating his 50th nomination. I already mentioned Mark Rylance's win, but in the other acting categories, Alicia Vikander won for her work in The Danish Girl as Best Supporting Actress, Brie Larson won for Room for Best Actress, and after all the waiting, Leonardo DiCaprio finally won for Best Actor in The Revenant, and the internet predictably went bananas. He's actually only lost four times before: What's Eating Gilbert Grape in 1994, The Aviator, Blood Diamond, and Wolf of Wall Street. So fifth time's the charm for Leo, and he gave a great speech. He clearly had time to rehearse. And he also spoke out about climate change, which may not have been the right time and place, but it is an important subject, so I applaud him for it. So with Leo's win, the internet can stop fawning over all those dumb memes. But I'd like to direct your attention to cinematographer Roger Deakins, who was also nominated last night and lost for the 13th consecutive time. He's never won, but he has done fantastic work. Last night he was up for Sicario, but he's also done the camera work for Shawshank Redemption, Skyfall, and 10 other nominated films. So if you're looking for another Oscars underdog to root for, Roger Deakins has been doing great work for two decades now. Alejandro González Iñárritu won Best Director for the second year in a row for his work on The Revenant, which I thought was a fantastic film. But in a surprising upset, that movie did not win Best Picture, which instead went to Spotlight. It won only one other award last night for Best Adapted Screenplay, which is the first time since 1953 that a Best Picture winner only took home two awards. And as Guardians of the Galaxy director James Gunn pointed out on Twitter, it's certainly an anomaly when director and picture go to two separate films. Honestly, some of the best moments of the night were the candid reaction shots and cutaways of the audience. Like Michael Keaton pumping his fist as he took the stage to accept Best Picture for Spotlight. Or child actor Jacob Tremblay's reaction to the Star Wars droids. And then Kate Winslet's emotional response when Leo finally won his trophy. All in all, it was a below-average telecast that focused a bit too much on the racism controversy, was full of surprises, and will be remembered as the year that Leonardo finally won. And once again, it also went 38 minutes long. I do not understand how professional television producers and directors can allow a ceremony to go that far over time. Like, even if you removed every single acceptance speech, the show still would have been like 10 minutes long. How do you plan a program that poorly? I'll never understand it. Well, there you have it. Those were the 88th Annual Academy Awards. If you have any thoughts, I would love to hear them in the comments below. And if you're new here, I do videos like this on news, sports, politics, and entertainment about two times a week, so please subscribe if you enjoyed this video. Thank you, as always, for watching and listening. My name is Jonathan Paula, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.